Welcome to Reading is Best channel. In this video, we will learn about ecological validity. In psychology, ecological validity refers to a measure of how test performance predicts behaviors in real-world settings. For example, test designs and findings in studies characterized by low ecological validity cannot be generalized to real-life situations, whereas those characterized by high ecological validity can be generalized to real-life situations. Generally, psychological experiments are conducted in laboratory, and if the result of those experiments are more generalizable outside the laboratory or in the real-world settings, then such experiments are thought to be more ecologically valid. In the article, Concepts of Ecological Validity, Their Differing Implications for Comparative Cognitive Research, Michael Cole, Louis Hood, and Raymond P. McDermott put forth the idea by psychologist Egon Brunswick to prevent the problems of research not representing the larger patterns of life. As per Brunswick, situations or tasks rather than people should be considered the basic units of analysis, and sampling of tasks and situations should be representative of the universe person happened to face in his physical and social environment. Actually, Egon Brunswick was the person who coined the term ecological validity. Let's take an example from the research titled Measuring Cognitive Distraction in the Automobile by David L. Strayer and his team at Utah University. This experiment was performed in three different settings: laboratory, driving simulator, and instrumented vehicle. First of all, let's talk about laboratory setting. 38 participants were chosen from Utah University. At first, baseline of cognitive workload was measured, where they had to perform a task without any distraction. Then participants had to engage in a series of distractions like listening to radio, listening to audiobook, talking in phone while performing the task. Even though the participants did not drive, the result of the experiment in the laboratory setting was concluded in the following way. As the cognitive workload associated with performing an activity increased, the cognitive distraction associated with performing that activity while operating a motor vehicle also increased. Now, depending on the generalizability of this experiment to real-world settings, we can conclude whether its ecological validity is low or high. If the result is more generalizable in real-world settings, then the experiment is thought to be more ecologically valid. Whereas, if the experiment is less generalizable to real-world settings, then the experiment is thought to be less ecologically valid. But experiment done in laboratory may not always be generalizable to real-world settings. So, to overcome the limitation of laboratory experiment, new technology like virtual reality and simulator are used. In the above-mentioned experiment, driving simulator was also used. In this setting, 32 participants from the Utah University participated. The simulator incorporated vehicle dynamics, traffic scenario, and road surface software to provide realistic scenes and traffic conditions. Beside the driving simulator, all the aspects of experiment were same. This experiment also showed increase in cognitive workload resulted in systematic changes in driving performance compared to non-distracted driving. Besides conducting this experiment in laboratory and simulator, researchers also conducted this experiment using instrumented vehicle to replicate the real-world setting as much as possible. As a whole, the patterns observed in the three experiments were found to be strikingly consistent, showing results from the laboratory and driving simulator were in good agreement with studies of cognitive distractions on the roadway. Since experiment in each setting showed systematic increase in cognitive workload as participants performed different in-vehicle activities, we might get tempted to conclude that the experiment is more ecologically valid. But still, what we have to understand is the main determining factor of ecological validity is whether the findings of the study can be generalized to real-life settings or not. These are the basic idea of ecological validity. Thank you for watching this video. If you liked the video, please click the like button. And if you have any kind of queries and suggestion, please comment in the comment box down below. For more videos like this, please subscribe to this channel.